we're Team Go Active Learning. My name is Daniel Wright.
I'm Jenny Candu.
And I'm Catherine Grinter.
And we're here to show you the updated version from our DP1 presentation. This is our DP2 presentation. So in the project management category, we updated our Gantt chart. Mainly what we've done since DP1 is all of our prototyping, our first physical mock-up, and most of our final physical mock-up. Our team is a little bit behind in the final physical mock-up stage, but we're working with our first physical mock-up, tweaking the designs a little bit so that we can finish up the final physical mock-up on time. For the design structure matrix, it's basically a chart that shows the different relations between the different tasks that we have in our Gantt chart. The relations are shown by the X's marked in the chart. So as you can see, the economic analysis is related to most every single task because our team always wants to consider economic factors with whatever we do. Also, our prototyping and first physical mock-up is an example of two tasks that we put in parallel. We put these in parallel because we wanted to finish them at the same exact time and do them simultaneously because they were so closely related with each other that we could do that.
Okay, so for the intellectual property, we found 5 patents related to IDEA. The first 3 are maze type patents, and the second 2 is an adjustable ramp, and then the last one is a pressurized rocket launcher. Now, these 5 patents give us similar ideas for station 1 and 2. We could have movable pieces in the station and create different paths for the kids to move the ball through the maze. And also, we could interchange the mazes, so like the mazes could each have different paths, and you can change the maze anytime you wanted to.
So for station 1, we came up with 6 different solutions for our station, and we have each of these here. We had 2 variations of 3 different designs. So we had 2 maze designs, 2 balance designs, and 2 shoot designs, where you have to work the ball through the maze, figure out which weights to put on a balance, or turn these knobs to get the correct path for the ball. And so we went through and we looked at all of our different criteria, such as the ease of use, the coverage of curriculum, and size and weight, but some were weighted more than others. We decided that it was more important to our team for the ease of use to be correct than for the size and weight to be smaller and lighter. And so we went through, and our 2 highest scoring designs were the 2 mazes. And to decide between the 2, we looked at each maze path individually. And maze 2 was not more challenging enough for a 4th grade level, and they could solve it too quickly. So we went for the maze 1, which forces students to work through the math problems and get the correct solution to the product.
So for station 2, these are the 6 solutions. The first 2 were made vertical mazes. The second 2 were a square arm and a circle arm. And then we had a call and a track. So we went with the second vertical maze. It's called the highest in the concept scoring. It was very easy to use. It met most of the curriculum, and it was very understanding, easy for 4th graders to use because we really focus on that. We don't want the 4th graders having a hard time using it, so it's called the highest.
Stations 3, similar to stations 1 and 2, had 3 main designs with a variation of each design. We had the dominoes design, the cup design, and the rotating arm design. So in the concept scoring, it's shown that the square arm, as shown above, ended up winning out over all the rest of the designs. Essentially, it had the highest scoring in all the most important weighted categories, so it was one of the easier ones to use. And comparing it to other solutions that scored similarly, the square dominoes almost won, but as you can see in the autonomy, it only scored a 0. And since this is the station we're using an Arduino for, that was higher weighted than size and weight, and so it ended up not winning over our square arm design. For station 1, the FMEA chart, here we can show all the main failures that could occur with our maze design. So our team found that the main problem we have is the hot glue. So with the hot glue, if it's laid on too thick on the bottom, then the marble will not be able to roll through the maze, and the student cannot successfully complete station 1. A way that we can fix this problem is just paying more money to our manufacturers so that the hot glue is laid the correct amount on to the wall to secure it onto the base. This will then decrease the occurrence and then therefore lower the RPM of the hot glue for the mace.
For station two, we had two main issues. The first issue was with the spinner. So if you look up here, you see that the ball falls through the maze. The ball falls through the maze and you twist it to go through the correct path. And sometimes the branches of these spinners are too long and they get caught, and then the ball will fall and get lost in the maze because you can't see where the ball is in the maze at the time. So that was a major issue. And the second major issue is the correct path is built into the design itself, so it is not easily varied, and it would be very easy for students to memorize the path and quickly avoid actually doing the math problems and just memorizing which way to turn the knobs. And so solutions to these problems, we would have to worry about making sure that our spinners are very precise and make sure they're not too long and they won't get caught on anything. Make sure that it's accurate every single time. And to solve our memorization problem, we were going to switch back and forth from the front and the back, and we can vary which way the ball needs to go for each part, and it will not be as easily memorized.
Okay, so for station three, our biggest problem is going to be the Arduino and the computer connection. So the lever arm is going to be connected to Arduino, which the Arduino is going to push the ball up the ramp. Now, if the lever is not connected to the Arduino properly and there's like missing connection, the lever would not move and the ball would not go up the ramp. So to prevent these failures, we basically just have to make sure that a port connection for the Arduino is in the right port, and then the computer is properly connected.
So for our investment proposal to VTEPS, we propose that they invest a total of $20,000 at the start of quarter one for our project. That way, when we have these expenses such as development costs and renting out the space for us to work in, we still have money in the bank to keep us moving when we don't have profits yet, because we don't start production until year two, and this is where we really start selling product and making money. And once we get into this phase of our 3-year-long project, we will be able to start paying back VTEPS. And we chose to pay back VTEPS over 5 quarters with equal payments of $5,371. This way, they are getting their money back in a more timely manner rather than a lump sum at the end of 3 years. Especially if for some reason our project would fail, they still get some reassurance throughout the project that they are getting money back as we go. And as you can see, we have a positive PW amount, which means that our project will be worthwhile, and VTEPS would be in their best interest to invest this money to us.
So in conclusion, our DP report basically summarized our progress so far in the BRG project. We completed a Gantt chart just to help us organize our tasks in this see which tasks we can complete first or complete together. For intellectual property, we found 5 patents that were submitted to us to help us gain some designs. And then for the concept generation section, it helped us choose a station for each product. Okay, and for the failure mode analysis, it helped us see future failure opportunities and helps us prevent them. And for the economic analysis, it helped us see how much we'll be getting for VTEPS and how we will be able to pay them back and when we will start making money. And our next step for this project will be to create a working prototype and create CAD models for the entire BRG. Thank you.